Hello and welcome. Today I bring you updates about Xenia and Xenia Canary, which have received a new user interface allowing for automatic project downloads and game-specific configurations. Additionally, the Xemu, an emulator for the classic Xbox, has started implementing the Vulkan API. Will this finally propel the emulator forward? Starting with Xemu, it has been surrounded by much controversy and is known for having a Discord community with extremely toxic moderators. For a long time, the emulator has not presented any significant updates. The last change was on June 8, 2023, over a year ago. However, there is a new highlight pull request, the implementation of the Vulkan API. Using the game Mercenaries Playground of Destruction and the already implemented API, OpenGL, at double the internal resolution, the game remains at 22 FPS, well below the ideal 60 FPS. However, with the Vulkan API, the game easily approaches 60 FPS. At the time of this video's publication, the project has finally moved from 76% of games considered playable and perfect to 85%. But don't get too excited, this list is contradictory, and I'll show you why. I tested 4 games this weekend after a clean installation of the project. The game Black, listed as playable with only minor audio issues during cutscenes, is totally unplayable, freezing during the long initial cutscenes. This problem is not unique to me. Another YouTube user also reported this in their game demonstration video on Xemu. Overall, this project's compatibility list is incomplete and inflated. I was once a tester for the project, and when I reported several games listed as playable that only reached the menu or didn't render correctly, I was banned. The reason? They prefer to have no report rather than a bad one. Therefore, if you report a problem, you will likely have your tester privileges revoked because they want only a full list of games, even if you can't get past the first part of the game. Since it had been a long time since I last tested this project, I decided to check if the major previous issues had been resolved. As mentioned earlier, Black did not run, only reaching the menu. Beatdown Fists of Vengeance is described as playable and only has issues with shadows. Indeed, the game is in this state, showing good speed and stability with the internal resolution multiplied by 3. I also tested a platform exclusive, Dead or Alive 3, which worked very well. Previous issues with slowdowns caused by large special effects or transparencies seemed to no longer exist. I didn't visit stages with rain or reflective floors, but explosions were fixed, and the game presents far fewer problems. Digimon Rumble Arena 2, which previously had a playable status but was impossible to play a match, now renders and runs very well but only at native resolution. The project still has issues with resolution scaling, so maintaining high resolutions is challenging. As you can see, there are still some incomplete requirements for the Vulkan API to be finally released publicly. Once the Vulkan API is fully implemented, I will perform comprehensive system tests and show my results, comparing OpenGL and Vulkan in Xemu. If you want to see a specific game, leave a comment, and I'll make a list as soon as the PR becomes public. Before we move on to Xenia, if you enjoy this type of content, please like the video so YouTube can share it with more people and subscribe to the channel to learn more about emulation. Since the Xenia team hasn't brought a user interface and separate game configurations, a project called Xenia Manager has emerged on GitHub some time ago, gaining relevance in recent weeks. Xenia Manager allows you to quickly switch between Xenia Canary and Xenia Master, maintaining separate configurations for each game along with a global configuration. Although this interface isn't as good as a native one, it simplifies many processes, such as installing updates or DLCs, which is usually complicated in Xenia Canary or Master and often results in errors. Want to install new content? Just right-click on the game and indicate where your new content is located. Additionally, you can migrate your saves from the previous Xenia version to the project by copying the content folder. If you want your shaders to be preserved, also copy the cache folders. The installation process is straightforward. Create a new folder, extract the contents of Xenia Manager, and run the file. In the first menu, you have the option to install Xenia Canary and Xenia Master, described as stable. I always recommend Xenia Canary. Click on the desired version, wait a few seconds, and click OK on the window that opens. On the main screen, if you want to customize, go to Settings and change the theme. Under Xenia Settings, you'll have a default profile, which is the global profile. All options changed here will be considered global configurations when adding new games. Below, there are some settings directly related to the installed GPU, such as the type of VSync you will use and the maximum number of frames that can be displayed. Keep in mind this is just a global limiter. Other settings will be directly inserted into the selected game. Now let's talk a bit about how to add your games. Xenia Manager is compatible with games in XEX and ISO formats, but I couldn't list any Xbox Arcade games. Adding games is very simple. Click on Add Game and select the corresponding XEX or ISO of the game. Upon correctly selecting your game, it will be checked by the emulator and will return to the Xenia Manager screen, where a window will appear for you to specify which project should open the game when you execute it. Then, a window will appear asking where you would like the manager to download the game information and covers from. After adding all your games, if you go to Xenia Settings, you can change important settings like resolution, VSync, and all other configurations. After making all the changes, just click on Save Changes and you can start your game. And that's the video, folks. I hope it was helpful to you. Thank you for watching, and see you next time.